Press the bell icon and never miss an update from Pharma Knowledge.
So in this case, your products are getting converted from aspirin to salicylic acid. The phenacetin is getting converted into paracetamol. So phenacetin is the prodrug. Paracetamol is not prodrug. What we are taking now in Crocin is paracetamol. Usme directly paracetamol hi hota. It's not phenacetin. So be clear with that. Sulfasalazine gets converted into two other active metabolites, which is mesalamine and sulfapyridine. Your pyrampicillin gets converted into ampicillin. Enalapril, we saw in the previous slide, it is enalaprilat. Same way, chloramphenicol palmitate gets converted into chloramphenicol. We need to remember all the examples of these prodrugs as well. Maintain a separate sheet where we'll be noting all the prodrugs as and when we come across different pharmacological chapters and medicam chapters on adding drugs to that particular list. Any questions still here? All the earlier doubts are answered, right? Anyone having any question in the previous part as well? Okay. Yes, it forms both metabolites at once. Wo beech se hi breakdown ho jata hai, ek saath dono metabolites banta. Uske aur bhi metabolites hai, but when you say it's conversion via prodrug, it's mesalamine and sulfapyridine. We'll see example of prodrugs in the upcoming slide. Don't worry. Let's go ahead. I guess all of you might be done writing. All right. So coming to next important part. Listen to questions which are possible from this particular slides as well. This is a drug. Your biotransformation reactions basically are divided into two types. One is phase one, another is phase two. So there are two types of metabolic reactions. Phase one is basically the initial phase, jahan pe ya to oxidation hoga, ya to reduction hoga, ya to hydrolysis hoga, or even cyclization and decyclization can occur. These five steps are a part of your phase one metabolism. After phase one metabolism, your drug may be activated. So when I say after phase one metabolism, drug may be activated, I am talking about prodrugs. Because prodrugs get activated after initial biotransformation, initial metabolism. So phase one reaction can actually activate the drug, or it may be unchanged. Unchanged in the sense, no change would be occurring after phase one metabolism. That usually happens for hydrophilic. So if the drug is hydrophilic, it already has some polar moieties. In such cases where the drug is already hydrophilic, it can directly go into phase two reactions as well. Not necessary that it will pass via phase one metabolism to the phase two metabolism. It can directly go to phase two metabolism for hydrophilic drugs. For hydrophobic or the lipophilic drugs, what we were talking initially, your hydrophobic or lipophilic drugs will first undergo phase one metabolism, where it can undergo oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis, or there are two more mechanisms, cyclization and decyclization. Sure, I'll repeat the idea. So we were talking about classification of biotransformation reactions. हम लोग ने phase one, phase two reactions की बात की. Phase one, your drug is basically undergoing phase one metabolism, where after phase one metabolism your drug can get activated. So phase one metabolism के बाद drugs तभी activated होते when they are prodrugs. So prodrugs after phase one metabolism like oxidation, reduction or hydrolysis can get activated, or they will be unchanged. Unchanged will only be the case when the drug is already hydrophilic. If the drug is already hydrophilic, it will directly enter into phase two metabolism. उसको phase one metabolism से कुछ लेना देना ही नहीं है फिर. And many times it might happen that the drug is inactivated there and there. So inactivation can also occur जब drug पहले से active है, उसका phase one metabolism होने के बाद it might turn into an inactive metabolite. एक बार oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis हो गया, next phase is that this undergoes phase two metabolism. Phase two metabolism में drug undergoes different conjugations. So वो conjugations का भी एक list है which we'll see in the next slide. After this conjugation occurs, except two metabolites majorly, rest all metabolites after conjugation are inactive. There are only two metabolites which after conjugation are active. It's there in the upcoming slide. Don't worry, I'll touch upon that as well. I hope you are done noting this. I'll move to the next slide. All right. So your phase one biotransformation reaction is also known as functionalization reaction or non-synthetic reaction. Here, either a functional generated or an existing functional group is exposed. When you say functional group is exposed, it would be NH attached to CH3. Those examples will come, don't worry. So by oxidation or by ND alkylation, I remove one of the group which will make it functionally active. I'll show that example later on. Don't worry about a functional group being exposed. I'll cover it with an example. When I say a functional group is generated, functional group is generated matlab agar pehle uspe se hydrogen tha, अब मैंने उसको ऑक्सीडेशन करके उसके हाइड्रोजन को OH कर दिया एंड ड्यू टू दिस OH नाउ इट हैज गॉट अ हाइड्रोक्सिल मेटाबोलाइट इट अंडरगोस फॉस्फास मेटाबॉलिज्म वेयर इन अ फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज बीइंग एडेड हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप ऐड कर दिया हियर योर मेटाबोलाइट मे बी एक्टिव और इनएक्टिव एज वी सॉ प्रीवियसली इफ इट्स अ प्रोड्रग योर फेज वन मेटाबोलाइट विल बी एक्टिव इन योर मेटाबोलाइट मेजरली देयर आर फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ रिएक्शन ऑक्सीडेशन reduction, hydrolysis, cyclization and decyclization. Your oxidation occurs majorly when it comes to phase 1 reactions. When we go to phase 2 reaction, your phase 2 reactions has two more names, conjugation and synthetic. Your metabolites of phase 2 reactions are mostly inactive only, except glucuronide conjugate of morphine and sulfate conjugate of minoxidil. Only these two metabolites which are conjugated metabolites are active. Or phase 2 metabolites are always inactive. Under phase 2 metabolism, there are different types of reactions like glucuronide conjugation, acetylation, methylation, sulfate conjugation, glycine conjugation, and glutathione conjugation. I repeat, under phase 2 metabolism, there are different reactions like glucuronide conjugation, acetylation, methylation, sulfate conjugation, glycine conjugation, and glutathione conjugation. In case of your phase 1 metabolism, majorly oxidation is occurring. Same in phase 2 metabolism, your major metabolism is glucuronide conjugation. So first maximum is glucuronide conjugation. After glucuronide conjugation, second maximum occurring metabolism is of your phase 2, which is glycine conjugation. So, pehle glucuronide conjugation sabse zyada hota hai, uske baad second maximum conjugation is of glycine conjugation, and then comes your sulfate and glutathione conjugation, which occurs almost equally for each and every possible reaction. After your sulfate and glutathione conjugation is your acetylation and methylation. We need to remember at least the one which occurs majorly. So phase 1 mein major occurring reaction is your oxidation. Phase 2 mein your majorly occurring reaction is glucuronide conjugation. After glucuronide in phase 2, it is amino acid conjugation is another term. Glycine conjugation, amino acid conjugation bhi bolte. So amino acid conjugation is another majorly occurring metabolism after glucuronide conjugation, followed by sulfate and glutathione conjugation, which occur almost equally, and then your acetylation and methylation. Rohit, not necessarily only hydrophobic drugs will undergo phase one metabolism. Many times even hydrophilic drugs undergo metabolism. So if the drug is already having one hydroxyl moiety, OH hai drug ke paas, to wo drug easily excrete ho sakta hai. But suppose wo drug ke paas ek ketone moiety bhi hai, C double bond O. तो अगर आप कीटोन मॉइटी का रिडक्शन करोगे विद द हेल्प ऑफ योर फेज वन मेटाबॉलिज्म यू विल कन्वर्ट दैट कीटोन इनटू अल्कोहल एंड दैट अल्कोहल विल ऐड मोर पोलैरिटी सो इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी के ड्रग्स ही फेज वन मेटाबॉलिज्म अंडरगो करेंगे इवन योर हाइड्रोफिलिक ड्रग्स कैन अंडरगो फेज वन मेटाबॉलिज्म आर द डाउट्स क्लियर टिल हियर आई रिपीट द एंटायर स्लाइड्स अप टू हियर डोंट वरी Now I just said one thing that it's not necessary that your hydrophobic drugs will only undergo phase 1. Even your hydrophilic drugs undergo phase 1 metabolism. Agar wo hydrophilic drug mein already ek OH moiety hai, एक हाइड्रोक्सिल मॉइटी ऑलरेडी, सपोज मान लो ये जो मैं बेंजीन बना रहा हूँ, फॉर अ मोमेंट टेक एन एग्जाम्पल दैट दिस इज सम ड्रग, अगर ये सेम ड्रग के ऊपर एक हाइड्रोक्सिल मॉइटी है, इन सच केसेस दिस ड्रग इज हाइड्रोफिलिक, सो आर अजम्पशन विल बी इट कैन डायरेक्टली गो टू फेज टू मेटाबॉलिज्म. बट एट द सेम टाइम इफ दिस ड्रग इज ऑल्सो हैविंग अ कार्बोनिल मॉइटी, कार्बोनिल मॉइटी इज सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ, इन सच केसेस वेयर द ड्रग इज ऑल्सो हैविंग कार्बोनिल मॉइटी, दिस सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ कैन अंडरगो रिडक्शन, जहां पर रिडक्शन के बाद ये सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ विल गेट कन्वर्टेड इंटू सी एच ओ एच. After this conversion from ketone to alcohol, it adds more polarity, so it can be excreted more easily out of the system. I hope the doubt is answered. Yes, hydrophilic as well as hydrophobic, both the types of drugs will undergo phase 2 metabolism. Conjugation ke bina drug removal is not that easy, so conjugation will always occur. When we look into phase 2 metabolism, we'll get more clarity on it. Let's get started with phase 1 reactions. So basically phase 1 reactions mein jaise hum log ne bola, at the end meko drug ko polar molecule mein convert karne ka, so we convert the lipophilic molecules into the polar molecules. Okay, polar molecules can be made by introducing a polar functional group, jaise hydroxyl group agar introduce kar diya to polarity add ho jayega, or unmasking a polar functional group. So suppose when you will see ahead, there are different drugs. In such drugs, you will find a structure where there is benzene, there is your NH2, and there is CH3. In such cases, if you observe, you will see that this drug is hydrophobic because there is no polar moiety directly involved. But after phase 1 metabolism, your phase 1 metabolism also involves N-D alkylation. When I say phase 1 metabolism involves N-D alkylation, N-D alkylation का मतलब है ये N पे जो alkyl group है वो उसको निकाल देगा. So that's what they are saying by introducing or unmasking a polar functional group. So polar functional group was there, but it was not available directly for metabolism. So they first remove this 3CH3 and it will unmask it. That's what we are saying over here. In phase 1 reaction, your pharmacological action of the drug may increase. Jaise hum log ne wo slide mein dekha, so it will increase for your prodrugs. It can decrease. Suppose wo parent active tha aur uska metabolite inactive hai. So after phase 1 metabolism, the pharmacological action of the drug will decrease. In rare cases, it remains unaltered as well. Let's look after example of some phase 1 reactions. So if you observe over here, now this image is taken from a Brahmankar. Now the reason to take the entire images, I just want to tell you, when it comes to your GPAT preparation, kya padhna hai, kya padhna hai. Don't get into wrong things or wrong part of that particular chapter. So phase 1 reactions, as we saw, it includes oxidation, it includes reduction, it includes hydrolysis, it includes cyclization, and it also includes decyclization. तो मैं यहाँ पे एट प्रेजेंट सिर्फ हाइड्रोलिसिस के रिएक्शन की बात कर रहा हूँ. सो वी हैव टेकन अ एस्टर, आवर एस्टर इज गोइंग टू अंडरगो हाइड्रोलिसिस. व्हेन आई से हाइड्रोलिसिस, आई एम गोइंग टू रिएक्ट इट विद वाटर. वाटर इज नथिंग बट योर HOH और H2O, व्हाटएवर यू से. इन सच केसेस योर एस्टर विल अंडरगो हाइड्रोलिसिस वेयर दिस RC डबल बॉन्ड O OR डैश विल गेट ब्रेक. योर R डैश will go with OH and it will form an alcohol. Here is your R dash OH, and your hydrogen will then take the position of this R dash, forming a carboxylic acid. So that's how ester on hydrolysis yields alcohol and carboxylic acid. Henceforth, मैं जो भी drug देखूंगा, अगर वो drug में एक ester functional group है, I repeat, henceforth, whichever drug I am seeing, if that drug has a ester functionality, after metabolism of hydrolysis, it will get converted into alcohol and carboxylic acid only. Henceforth, कोई भी drug आए, जिसमें ester functional group होगा, मैं directly उसका एक alcohol बनाऊंगा and एक carboxylic acid बनाऊंगा. So when I'm studying biotransformation from Brahmankar for GPAT, मेरे को सिर्फ ये general reaction पता होना चाहिए. I am not concerned with this all things. So गलती से भी डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम ऑन सच प्लेसेस. टेकन दिस एग्जांपल ओवर हियर वेयर यू अवॉइड अनरिक्वायर्ड थिंग्स फॉर जीपैट प्रिपरेशन. हेंस फॉर आगे के स्लाइड्स में मैंने सब प्रिसाइज चीजें ही ली है. ओनली हियर आई टुक वन एडिशनल पार्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड कौन सा चीज जीपैट के लिए नहीं चाहिए. उस चीज पे फोकस मत करना. डोंट वेस्ट योर टाइम ऑन सच टॉपिक्स. लेट्स गो अहेड. So now we are getting into specific oxidation reaction firstly. So as we know, your oxidation is the most important drug metabolizing reaction from phase one. It is the majorly occurring one as well. We all are aware your oxidation basically means either addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen. That is what we basically mean by the term oxidation. Now one by one we'll see example of वो ड्रग्स के जो एग्जांपल्स है इट्स द सेम वे यू आर सपोज टू सॉल्व फॉर एनी ऑफ योर मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री ड्रग एज वेल. फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री में जितने भी ड्रग्स आगे जाके आएंगे वो सबके लिए ये चीज कॉमनली अप्लाई हो सकती है. तो प्लीज ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड हाउ इट वर्क्स. इफ एट ऑल यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड पुट इट इन द चैट बॉक्स. आई विल रिपीट इट. लेट्स स्टार्ट. बेसिकली देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. वन ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन इज नोन एज हाइड्रोक्सीलेशन. हाइड्रोक्सीलेशन का मतलब क्या है? सपोज एक बेंजीन रिंग है. आई एम जस्ट मेकिंग अ बेंजीन रिंग. सो वी ऑल नो बेंजीन रिंग इज बेसिकली C6H6. तो बेंजीन के हर एक कार्बन पे एक एक हाइड्रोजन होगा. आई विल जस्ट मेक ऑल द सिक्स हाइड्रोजन्स. यू कैन पैरेलली कीप नोटिंग इन योर बुक्स. ओके. So there are six hydrogens on your benzene. After your oxidation, oxidation is what? Oxidation is addition of oxygen. So after addition of your oxygen, what can happen is one of your hydrogens will get converted into hydroxyl group. So अब ये polar हो गया. इस पे alcohol functionality आ गया. Basically हुआ तो इसका oxidation ही है. But that oxidation has actually introduced a hydroxyl group. So you see various types of oxidation reactions include hydroxylation. That was the first one. Then you have oxygenation at carbon, nitrogen and sulfur. Just note this down. I have examples for that as well. Then you have other oxidations where you say N or O dealkylation. N dealkylation ka example last slide mein dekha. Wo NH2CH3 tha. Maine wo CH3 group nikal diya. Even that removal is noted as oxidation because it is N dealkylation. Wo CH3 mein aapne 3 hydrogen bhi nikale. Removal of hydrogen is known as oxidation. That's the reason N-D alkylation is a part of your oxidation reactions. And the last one, oxidative deamination. Just note down this four as of now. I'll taking one by one all the examples. Let's go to the first example. Before moving on to individual reactions of this four types, one important thing, all your oxidation reactions will require a group of monooxygenases enzyme. This group of monooxygenases enzyme basically include NADPH, CYP450 hemoprotein, CYP450 reductase and your molecular oxygen. So there are basically four enzymes which are involved in your group of monooxygenases which are required for oxidation. NADPH, CYP450 hemoprotein, CYP450 reductase and molecular oxygen. When it comes to example of O-dealkylation would also go the same way. Suppose you take an example जहाँ पे एक benzene ring है, benzene ring के आगे oxygen है, वो oxygen पे CH3 attached है. So when you do reaction for this, it can be different ways. It can be benzene CH2OCH3 or it can be benzene OCH3 simply. You basically remove CH3 group. And it gets converted from benzene OCH3 to, just a minute, I'll erase this. It will get converted from your benzene OCH3 to simply benzene OH. That's how your OD alkylation works. It will just remove the alkyl group which is involved. Jaise ND alkylation mein alkyl group nikala tha. Same way when it comes to OD alkylation mein bhi alkyl group ही निकलेगा, the one which is attached on your oxygen and only your hydrogen will be remaining. Is the doubt answered? Okay, let's go ahead. First example. स्टार्ट ऑन नोटिंग डाउन दिस एग्जाम्पल्स, आगे जाके और ड्रग्स है उसके एग्जाम्पल्स लिखने पड़ेंगे. एंड डोंट वरी, henceforth whenever such questions come up you can actually apply this metabolism directly to your pharmaceutical drug, pharmaceutical medicinal chemistry directly apply kar sakte. Now this I have not taken as a drug, I have just taken an example. So this is the structure of acetanilide. Acetanilide is benzene pe NH C double bond O CH3, so everything stays the same. This is your benzene. Ye benzene ke har ek position pe hydrogen hai, yahan pe hydrogen hai, yahan pe hydrogen hai, yahan pe hydrogen hai, यहाँ पे हाइड्रोजन है, एंड इवन दिस पोजिशन एज हाइड्रोजन जस्ट द वे लाइक योर आफ्टर योर ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन दिस हाइड्रोजन विल गेट कन्वर्टेड इन टू हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप वेर ऑक्सीजन इज बींग एडेड. सो दिस हाइड्रोजन इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड इन टू हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप, इट हैज गिवन इट अ फंक्शनल मोइटी एज वेल, एंड दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज नथिंग बट पैरासिटामोल, द वन विच इज प्रेजेंट इन प्रोसीन. सो दैट oxidation has actually led to a active drug as well. Well, acetanilide is not a drug, so we don't consume it. It's just being taken over taken as an example over here that acetanilide can have addition of your oxygen. अभी हमको इसमें से सीखना क्या है? At majority of the places, your hydrogen of the benzene ring can be converted into a hydroxyl group with the help of your process known as oxidation. सिर्फ एक oxygen add करना है और हमको उस हाइड्रोजन को OH में कन्वर्ट कर देना. इज दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टेप बीइंग अंडरस्टूड? एनी डाउट्स, एनी क्वेरीज? आई होप यू आर नोटिंग डाउन द एग्जांपल्स पैरेलली. गोइंग टू द नेक्स्ट वन. दिस इज नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल. पहले मैं सिंपली वो बेंजीन पे NHCH3 बता रहा था, बट नाउ आई हैव टेकन अ स्पेसिफिक एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ ड्रग. सो मेथैम्फेटामाइन इज अ ड्रग. फॉर योर मेथैम्फेटामाइन, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द स्ट्रक्चर, सर दिस इज अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन या ऑक्सीजनेशन. आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट अगेन. इफ यू ऑब्जर्व व्हेन यू ऑन एनी सब्स्टिट्यूशन इज बीइंग कन्वर्टेड इनटू OH, this conversion from hydrogen to OH, the difference is of oxygen. You have added only an oxygen. Addition of oxygen is nothing but oxidation. जब आपने वो oxygen add किया, तब आपने उस hydrogen को hydroxyl में convert किया. That's the reason you call hydroxylation as a part of oxidation reaction. Is the doubt answered? Great. Coming back to the drug which we took up, is there any specific criteria which hydrogen should be there is no such specific criteria. It can occur at different hydrogen. You can't generalize ki hamesha uska para position ka hi hoga ya kuch. Not necessary. It will differ and it will vary. Methamphetamine. Methamphetamine ka structure is benzene CH2 CH pe NH3 and again NH CH3. If you observe over here, this example is of your N-D alkylation. So, NH पे जो CH3 था, वो CH3 निकाल दिया. Firstly, ये CH3 में से एक हाइड्रोजन ये NH को दे दिया. ये CH3 में से एक हाइड्रोजन उस NH को ही दे दिया. That's why this NH now becomes NH2. Now, since out of this CH3 one hydrogen has gone to NH, we are left with only two more hydrogens. Those two hydrogens I am writing separately. Instead of writing them CH2, I have written it HCH. And since I am doing oxidation, I am adding oxygen. So I have added oxygen. So the phase one metabolite of methamphetamine after oxidation has given me formaldehyde and amphetamine. So this is another example. I hope you are writing down things. Methyl reaction is different. यहाँ पे N demethylation हो रहा है, demethylation हो रहा है. D मतलब removal, methylation मतलब methyl निकाल रहा हूँ. Not necessarily मैं हमेशा methyl group ही निकालूंगा, it can be any alkyl group. Methyl के बदले कल यहाँ पे ethyl होगा, propyl होगा, anything it can be. That's why you call it dealkylation. You remove that particular alkyl group. Let's go ahead. Coming to another example. I just pick up different examples to highlight what are those reactions. तो हम लोग ने पहले hydroxylation का एक example already देखा. hydroxylation, and there is another question in the chat box saying what is the difference between hydroxylation and oxygenation. Oxygenation ke wajah se wahan pe hydroxyl group ban raha hai. So that hydroxyl group is actually a byproduct after oxidation, and your oxygenation will not necessarily always hydrogen. Or oxygenation can occur with different functional groups as well. अगर मैं यहाँ का ही एग्जाम्पल ले लू, ऑक्सीजन ऐड हुआ है बट एट द एंड मेरे को हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप नहीं मिला, मेरे को एल्डिहाइडिक ग्रुप मिला. इज द डाउट आंसर्ड श्रीति? ग्रेट. तो पहले हम लोग ने एक हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन का एग्जाम्पल देखा जहां पे एसिटोनिलेट से OH ऐड हुआ था. देन वी सॉ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एंड अल्काइलेशन, तो यहाँ से वो मिथाइल ग्रुप निकला था. देन गोइंग अहेड we are seeing next example, which is of oxygenation at your C, N or S. So here I have taken example of oxygenation at imipramine is the drug. Imipramine, if you remember, was there initially as well. So imipramine ka structure hai ye. Hum log ko yahan pe sirf structure likhna hai just to put it across that how does this occur. No need to remember any structure. In future, whenever you see such drugs, you can write N oxide metabolites. But important thing to note, when it comes to different metabolism, your hydroxylation occurs to a good extent, your N or O dealkylation occurs to a good extent, but oxygenation at carbon, nitrogen and sulfur and oxidative deamination, these two are rare. सबसे ज्यादा common metabolite ये होता है जहां पे भी hydrogen है वो hydrogen को OH कर सकते हो. Majority of the reactions you will find it. It won't be a problem. Don't worry about that particular phase. That was with two reactions, your hydroxylation and N or O dealkylation. Then with your oxygenation at carbon, nitrogen or sulfur, here I have taken specific example of nitrogen. Ho sakta wo carbon pe bhi ho aur wo sulfur pe bhi hota hai. Minoxidil mate is oxide metabolite as well. So same way here, oxygenation at your nitrogen can occur over here, where your imipramine N oxide will be a metabolism. One important thing to remember, it is not necessary कि हमेशा ऐसा होगा. This N will get converted into N oxide. It's for few specific drugs. So जहाँ पे भी N दिखेगा उसका straightforward N oxide मत बना देना. N oxide metabolites are rare compared to your hydroxylation and oxidative deamination. ये example same ही है. पहले nitrogen पे oxidation ने देखा था. Now we are seeing oxygenation at sulfur. This is the structure of your phenothiazine. दो बेंजीन रिंग एन आर एंड सल्फर. सो हियर यू आर गेटिंग एस ऑक्साइड. अब यूजुअली तुम लोग इसका भी एन ऑक्साइड बना देते थे. दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, योर एन ऑक्साइड, एस ऑक्साइड, सी ऑक्साइड मेटाबोलाइट्स आर देयर, दे वोंट अप्लाई एवरी टाइम. सो बी स्पेसिफिक विद व्हाट यू. हम लोग को सिर्फ एन और एस ऑक्साइड के लिए याद रखना पड़ेगा किसका क्या बनता है. बाकी हाइड्रोक्सिल एंड एन डी अल्काइलेशन एंड ऑल वी कैन डू एनी डे, दे आर वेरी कॉमन. Yes, for phenothiazine you can do N-D alkylation as well, but your N-D alkylation majorly occurs when it's a part of the branching. Here it's a part of a ring, so this would be rare. जब वो branching का part होगा, it can go ahead. Phenothiazine के बारे में I said that sulfur का S oxide metabolism हो रहा है, so here that S oxide metabolite is. At times you might also make N oxide metabolite, but N oxide metabolite is not the case over here. So please don't blindly make N oxide metabolites. That's not common. तुम hydroxylation बहुत जगह तुमको मिलेगा and you will find N or O dealkylation as well. But this one and this one are rare. So don't make these two metabolites everywhere. I hope all the questions are answered. Let's go ahead. Okay. इसमें oxidation reactions है. I have not taken up all the reactions. I have taken the specific ones which will give you a better insight. So if you observe over here, we are doing oxidation of olefins. Olefins is nothing but your alkenes, double bonded carbons. So this is the structure of carbamazepine. Carbamazepine is an anti epileptic drug. So jab main anti epileptic drug karunga tab main uska ye metabolism karne hi wala hu. I have taken same example over here as well. This is a carbamazepine jahan pe double bond hai at position 10 and 11. When I am doing oxidation for carbamazepine, I am making a epoxide ring. I repeat, when I am doing oxidation for carbamazepine, I am making an epoxide ring. इसी में epoxide ring पर आगे मैं hydrolysis कर रहा हूँ. तो ये जो metabolism दिखा रहा हूँ, इधर oxidation हुआ है, which is a phase one metabolism. Then I had hydrolysis, which is again a phase one metabolism. Both metabolisms I have shown over here. One is oxidation, another is hydrolysis. Hydrolysis में epoxide ring break हो गया है and it is being converted into a diol. दो OH group आ गया. I hope everything is clear till here. Yeah, we need to remember isomerism over here, but it from biotransformation point of view, no need to get in depth till here. Just remember that your epoxide ring can be break as well with the help of hydrolysis, where your epoxide can be converted into diols. Going to the next one, oxidation of benzylic carbon atoms. So when I say oxidation of benzylic carbon atoms, firstly मैं benzylic बोल रहा हूँ. Benzyl means benzene पे CH3. Benzyl means benzene पे CH3. So I'm talking about this benzylic carbon atom. The structure is of tolbutamide. ये same metabolism आपको anti-diabetic drug में आएगा. Tolbutamide is an anti-diabetic drug. We'll find the same metabolism over there. Now the metabolism what we have written for tolbutamide, that usually you can apply to any drug which is having CH3 branching on it. To a very good extent, it's a very common metabolite. Oxidation of benzylic carbon atom में होता क्या है? Benzene के ऊपर जो carbon atom है, which is this CH3, this CH3 undergoes oxidation. जब आप ये CH3 को oxygen add करते हो, you have basically converted that CH3 into CH2OH. मैंने सिर्फ oxygen add किया है, मैंने hydroxyl group add नहीं किया, I've just added oxygen. उसके पास पहले तीन hydrogen थे, तो उसने उसको CH3 साथ में लिखा था. अब उसने वो CH3 को CH2 ऑक्सीजन जो मैंने ऐड किया था वो वाला ऑक्सीजन और एक उसका हाइड्रोजन ऐसे CH2OH करके लिखा. सो इट इज द सेम CH3, ओनली ऑक्सीजन इज बीइंग एडेड बाय मी. तो CH2OH हो गया. गोइंग अहेड, इट इज रिएक्टेड विद अल्कोहल डीहाइड्रोजिनेज. डी मींस रिमूवल, हाइड्रोजन, हाइड्रोजिनेज मतलब हाइड्रोजन का रिमूवल. सो नाउ रिमूवल ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इज ऑल्सो नथिंग बट ऑक्सीडेशन, जैसे हम लोगों ने इनिशियली देखा. तो यहाँ पे हाइड्रोजन्स निकालने वाले हम लोग, वी हैव रिमूव टू हाइड्रोजन्स एंड दिस अल्कोहल मॉइटी इज नाउ अगेन अंडरगोइंग ऑक्सीडेशन वेयर इट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू एल्डिहाइड. सो इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू एल्डिहाइड. इफ यू डू ऑक्सीडेशन फर्दर फॉर एल्डिहाइड, इट गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. सो हियर इज योर कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड, दैट्स हाउ इट गोस. CH3 से CH2OH बना विद द हेल्प ऑफ ऑक्सीडेशन. Further, by removal of hydrogen, removal of hydrogen is nothing but oxidation again. So this CH2OH got converted into CHO, which is an aldehyde group, and this CHO then further became carboxylic acid, which is COOH. I hope everything is clear till here and you are noting down these examples. This wavy lines basically represent that the structure is same for the rest part. इसके लिए उसको wavy lines लिखा है. तुमको ऐसा लिखना allowed नहीं होगा, तुमको लिखना पड़ेगा. Difference between reductase and dehydrogenase, they are exactly opposite. When you say reductase, उसमें reduction होगा, there will be addition of hydrogen. Dehydrogenase मतलब मैं hydrogen निकालूंगा, so it would be indirectly meaning oxidation. I can see one question. Question will be based on structure of the molecules or the name of the drug will be given. Okay, so when it comes to your entrances, you will have name of the drug, aspirin or prodrug, or I will tell you simply question of NIPER paper 2015, which among the following is a prodrug, and there were four examples for it. So you basically need to buy out the name of prodrugs. When it comes to such structures, when you are doing your structures of pharmaceutical chemistry, medicinal chemistry, you need to do metabolism for all those drugs. So there is no need to buy out metabolites for those drugs when it comes to your GPAT. GPAT के लिए मैं सिर्फ उसके active metabolites का नाम याद रखूँगा, nothing else. And if it's a prodrug. Is the doubt cleared, Kinnari? I said that if I am doing biotransformation from entrance point of view, the questions are like, which among the following is a prodrug? And char drugs ke naam rahenge, aspirin, sulindac, chloramphenicol palmitate, all of the above. So they won't give you the structure. हमको सिर्फ उसके नाम याद रखने पड़ेंगे मेजरली व्हेन इट कम्स फॉर एंट्रेंस. द रीजन व्हाई वी आर डूइंग बायो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम स्ट्रक्चरल एस्पेक्ट्स ओवर हियर इज व्हेन यू विल डू मेटाबोलाइट्स ऑफ योर ड्रग्स ऑफ मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री दैट टाइम यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड जो कॉमन मेटाबोलाइट है वी कैन अवॉइड दैट एंड द वंस व्हिच आर स्पेशल मेटाबोलाइट्स व्हिच आर एक्टिव मेटाबोलाइट्स विल बी आवर फोकस एरिया टू टेक अहेड. All right. Let's proceed ahead. So before going ahead, we'll have a quick revision. Let's catch hold of someone. I'll do that. Right. So we started with the chapter of biotransformation. From biotransformation, initially before going to that, we saw about ADME. So your ADME is basically absorption during which the drug gets into the bloodstream. After distribution, the drug goes to the site of action, followed by metabolism, where the drug is changed into a polar form, after which the drug is excreted from the human system. And during the excretion, the drug leaves the body. For the drug to be excreted from this human system, it should have an optimum hydrophilicity as well. If the drug is lipophilic in nature, it will be beneficial since the lipophilic nature of the drug will allow it to pass through the biological membranes and to reach the site of action, but it will hinder in the excretion process. In order for the drug to be excreted easily, it should also have an optimum hydrophilicity. In such cases, HLB of the drug becomes very important. It should have an optimum hydrophilic balance wherein the drug is excreted from the human system. Going ahead, we talked about the drug excretion via renal route. So if the drug is supposed to be excreted via renal route, it requires the drug to be hydrophilic in nature. After that, we talked about biotransformation as a core. So biotransformation basically includes chemical alteration of the drug in the body. So during the chemical alteration of the drug in the body, some changes will be made whereby the chemical nature of the drug will be altered. This chemical nature alteration basically helps the drug to become more polar, after which the drug is removed from the body. Such mechanisms helps to protect from ingested toxins and also helps to deal with environmental xenobiotics. When we say environmental xenobiotics, those are basically foreign substances. If the drug is polar or lipid soluble, then after biotransformation, it is converted into polar water soluble forms. And if the drug is already hydrophilic, in such cases, there is very little biotransformation and the drug is majorly excreted unchanged. Going ahead, we saw sites for drug metabolism. So in sites for drug metabolism, there are various sites where metabolism occurs. Liver is the primary site of drug metabolism, where the majority part of your drug metabolism occurs. After liver, it is followed by lungs, kidney, intestine, placenta, adrenals, and skin. What is more important for us to remember is your highest rate of drug metabolism is at liver. That is the reason it's known as primary site of drug metabolism. And the lowest rate of drug metabolism is at skin. Going ahead, we saw a table which basically gives us an idea about the drug and its metabolites. So if the drug is active and the metabolite is inactive or less active, the effect is only cause of parent drug. Majority of the drugs belong in this category. Examples are ibuprofen, lidocaine, paracetamol. Then we saw example where your drug is also active and your metabolite is also active. In such cases where the drug is also active and metabolite is also active, your pharmacological effect is totally due to parent drug and metabolite. So they both will support the therapeutic activity. Such examples include codeine, which is being converted into morphine, digitoxin being converted into digoxin, and diazepam being converted into oxazepam. Further ongoing, we saw about prodrugs. Prodrugs is basically including inactive parent and active metabolites. Such type of drugs are known as prodrugs. The reason to make prodrugs is they are more stable. They provide better bioavailability and desirable pharmacokinetics along with less side effects. Here, your pharmacological effect is totally because of metabolite. So your nature is active in that case. In such cases, example includes your levodopa being converted into dopamine and your enalapril being converted into enalaprilat. Going ahead, we saw different metabolisms where drug and its metabolite, they both are active. So such cases where drug is also active and metabolite is also active, there may be change in pharmacological activity or there may be no change in pharmacological activity. We'll have both the types of cases. In cases where there is no change in pharmacological activity, initially the drug is amitriptyline. After metabolism, it is being converted into nortriptyline. But they both act as antidepressant only. On parallel lines, emipramine after metabolism will be converted into desimipramine. We saw two examples where the drug after metabolism is having change in their pharmacological activity. Likewise, if you take example of Iproniazid is basically an antidepressant drug, but after metabolism, it gets converted into isoniazid, which is an anti-tubercular drug. So after metabolism, the activity of drug has changed. It's become anti-tubercular from antidepressant. Going ahead, we talked about diazepam. Diazepam is a tranquilizer, which after metabolism is converted into an active metabolite known as oxazepam, which is anticonvulsant in action. So the activity is changing. We'll see example of diazepam and oxazepam as well in the upcoming slides. Going ahead, then we saw examples of different products. And yes, we need to add all these examples. Aspirin being converted to salicylic acid, phenacetin being converted into paracetamol, sulfasalazine being converted to mesalamine and sulfapyridine, pimampicillin into ampicillin, enalapril to enalaprilat, and chloramphenicol palmitate converted to chloramphenicol. Just to give you a bit of industry insights, enalapril has a very good commercial market, and the brand which is selling highest in market for enalapril is with the brand name of Envas. ENVAS. Envas is a branded product of Cadila Pharmaceuticals. I said Envas is a branded product of Cadila Pharmaceuticals. The drug is enalapril malate. It's the malate salt form of drug. Here, we need not buy out brand names of all the drugs. We need to do it to some specific drugs. It's not necessary that you need to remember brand names of all the drugs. Here also for enalapril, it's not required, but just the general knowledge part of it. Going ahead, after prodrugs, next what we saw was classification of biotransformation reactions. We saw about phase 1 and phase 2. So if the drug is hydrophobic meaning lipophilic, in such cases, the drug first undergoes phase 1 biotransformation. In phase 1 biotransformation, you have oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis, cyclization, and decyclization. After phase 1 metabolism, the drug might get activated. So a prodrug will get activated after phase 1 metabolism, or it may be unchanged or often inactivated as well. If the drug is hydrophilic in nature, in such cases, the drug might directly go into phase 2 metabolism. No need of going through phase 1 metabolism. And whatever conjugation products will be formed, those conjugation products are usually inactive except two conjugates, glucuronide conjugate of morphine and sulfate conjugate of minoxidil. Only these two conjugates are active. This is must to be remembered. We also saw other names for reactions, which is functionalization reaction. Pimampicillin is given as a prodrug. Ampicillin is the active form. So another name for phase 1 or your functionalization reaction is non-synthetic reaction. For phase 2, another name is conjugation reaction or synthetic reactions. In your phase 1 reaction, the functional group is generated, just as we saw hydrogen say hydroxyl ho jata, or instead of that, a functional group may be exposed. Jaise wo NH2CH3 hoga, to NH2CH3 se wo NH2 pe convert ho jayega. The major metabolism which occurs for phase 1 is oxidation. The major metabolism which occurs for phase 2 is usually glucuronidation. Maximum metabolism of phase 2 is by glucuronidation, followed by acetylation, methylation. After glucuronidation, the second most is amino acid conjugation. Glycine conjugation occurs. I have written that as the second maximum one. Or else you might also find instead of glycine conjugation, some options saying amino acid conjugation. So don't forget, glycine is a amino acid. Followed by your sulfate conjugation, equally with your glutathione conjugations. And then you have acetylation and methylation as well. Going ahead, we started with phase 1 reactions where a polar moiety is being introduced or gets unmarked. And due to your pharmacological action of the drug, due to phase 1 metabolism, might get increased, decreased, or it may remain unaltered. We saw example of hydrolysis, wherein a ester drug was getting converted into carboxylic acid and alcohol. So then we saw oxidation involves addition of oxygen or your removal of hydrogen. Your various oxidation reactions are hydroxylation, oxygenation at carbon, nitrogen, or sulfur atoms, N or O dealkylation, and oxidation. So we have taken into account what are the prerequisites for oxidation to occur. So those are your cytochrome P450 enzymes, cytochrome enzymes of heme protein, then your RNDPH and your molecular oxygen, which is O2. Then we went on to see individual examples of all this reaction. So acetanilate ka dekha tha humne, hydrogen se OH ho raha tha, which is nothing but hydroxylation. Then we went on to see another example wherein a methamphetamine was being converted into amphetamine. So this is basically N-D alkylation. After that, next example what we saw was conversion from imipramine to imipramine N-oxide. So that was oxygenation at nitrogen. Then we saw example of phenothiazine, jahan pe sulfur se sulfur oxide bana tha. Then we saw oxidation of your olefins where a peroxide ring is being formed. And this peroxide ring, after undergoing epoxide hydrolase reaction of hydrolysis, is being converted into a diol. And then we saw oxidation of benzylic carbon atoms, jahan pe hum log ne toll-butamide ka oxidation dekha tha, jahan se wo CH3 se CH2OH ho jata hai. After CH2OH, it becomes CHO and carboxylic acid final. So this is where we stop. I can see few questions in the chat box. Yes, Neil, pivampicillin and ampicillin goes the same as your paracetamol and phenacetin. You give paracetamol and you don't give phenacetin. But in case of ampicillin and pivampicillin, you actually give pivampicillin. Treatment mein pivampicillin dete, it gets converted in vivo to ampicillin. Ampicillin has few hydrolytic issues. When we'll do penicillins as a topic, we'll look into metabolism of it. Penicillin G, penicillin V, agar ye sab suna hoga, you will be able to correlate. And yes, rifampicin is an antituberculin drug. If you remember, I don't think this is a part of anyone's classification, but even this is a marketed product which is going great in South Africa. So rifapentin is another prodrug. This rifapentin prodrug is an antitubercular drug. I have just a minute, I'm forwarding that same example in the chat box. So rifapentin is your prodrug. Your rifapentin, which is your prodrug, is basically prodrug of your rifampicin. So your rifapentin is prodrug and active metabolite is your rifampicin. This is till where we did in our first hour. We'll go ahead from here. Anyone has anything to ask or can we go ahead? I think there are no questions, so let's go ahead. So this is next example. Now you can apply this type of oxidation to a good amount of drugs where your alpha carbon, so we are saying oxidation of carbon atoms, alpha to carbonyl and amines. Let's observe the functional groups. Carbonyl and amines ka baat kiya. So carbonyl group is your this one, C double bond O. Your amine group is this one, C double bond N. Okay, so this is your carbonyl group, this is your amine group. Ye dono ka alpha carbon matlab ye wala carbon jahan pe 3 likha hai. So this is your alpha carbon. I've made the symbol of alpha there as well. Your oxidation of alpha carbon, sorry, your oxidation of carbon atoms, alpha to carbonyl and amines. So this is that common alpha carbon. Ye carbon pe oxidation hota hai. Initially there were two hydrogens over here. Har ek carbon ka valency 4 hota hai. Yahan pe ek carbon hai. Wo carbon already two bond bana chuka hai. One is going this way, another is going this way. So there are two more bonds over here which are with hydrogen. Uska hydroxylation hoga to ye oxidation hoga to ye hydrogen OH mein convert ho jayega. So that is one OH. And another one will be hanging as it is, which is your hydrogen. So this is the same structure which we did initially, jahan pe hum log ne baat kiya tha, diazepam ka active metabolite is oxazepam. So this is your oxazepam. You can call it N-methyl oxazepam as well. It doesn't matter. Or you can simply call it oxazepam as well. It's okay. Please note down this example. Yes, the number 3 is for the position. This is your position number 1, this is your position number 2, and this is your position number 3. That's how the numbering for this benzodiazepines go. So benzodiazepines ka numbering, it's a different part altogether. Taking it over, seeing oxidation of carbon atoms, alpha to carbonyl and amines. So your carbonyl group is this one, your amine group is this one. ये दोनों अलग अलग ग्रुप्स हुए. अल्फा कार्बन मतलब फंक्शनल ग्रुप के बाजू वाला कार्बन. तो ये दोनों आपके फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स है. फंक्शनल ग्रुप के बाजू वाला कार्बन मतलब ये वाला कार्बन. सो दिस इज योर अल्फा कार्बन विच इज नंबर डैश थ्री. तो ये कार्बन पे ऑक्सीडेशन होगा. व्हेन ऑक्सीडेशन विल अकर एट दिस कार्बन, आउट ऑफ द टू हाइड्रोजन विच इज एट दिस थर्ड पोजिशन, वन ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन विल बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप एंड अनदर हाइड्रोजन विल बी एज इट इज. कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल, I have taken very typical examples which will actually help you to get clear with your same drugs which will come ahead. So valproic acid is also an anti-epileptic drug. We'll come across this in that. No need to remember enzymes in this reactions. In phase 1 reaction, there is no need to remember enzymes. Phase 2 mein bahad karna padega. So don't worry about phase 1 reactions as of now. So I've taken an example of a drug which is valproic acid. Valproic acid का structure you can see over here. So valproic acid is the anti-epileptic drug as I told you. Here there is carboxylic acid. This carboxylic acid is on your CH. So CH के ऊपर COOH है, and that CH is attached to a three carbon system twice. यहाँ पे भी three carbon system है, यहाँ पे भी three carbon system. Okay, so it is CH COOH. And a propyl group at both the positions. Taking it ahead, there are two types of oxidation occurring over here. So if you go on numbering this carbons, abhi ye functional group hai. So if you number this, this would come to omega. Agar alpha, beta, gamma, omega aise kiya to. You can give it any representation. We are not bothered about that over here. When you say omega oxidation, this particular this end carbon will be converted, ye CH3 ka oxidation hoga, ye CH3 se CH2 OH ho ja raha hai, to CH3 ka hydrogen gaya, ye CH3 ke badle CH2 likha aur ek oxygen andar aa gaya. This is your CH2 OH, this is one of your metabolite and this is a minor product. If you observe, ab ye functional group alcoholic group ho gaya since it is CH2 OH. This functional group alcohol is actually a primary alcohol, right? It is attached to one carbon only. So when a functional group is attached to one carbon, it is a primary alcohol. Now observe another metabolite which is omega minus one. So if this carbon is known as omega, omega minus one मतलब उसके पहले वाला carbon. तब ये वाले carbon पे उन लोगों ने OH attach किया है. तीन चीज की है. वो CH2 का H वो oxygen को गया है and from CH2 it has become CH. So this is your another metabolite. Now this metabolite is known as major product, while this metabolite is known as minor product. Reason being, this is a primary alcohol. Primary alcohol is less stable compared to a secondary alcohol, and rather this is not a secondary alcohol. This is actually, yeah, sorry, this is secondary alcohol. So since this is your secondary alcohol always is more stable compared to your primary alcohol. That's the reason this is a major product and this is a minor product. I hope you are getting the difference. Coming to another example. Now, even this is a very classical example, ibuprofen. Ibuprofen is a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug. It's an NSAID. If you observe, there are multiple metabolites for NSAIDs. There are multiple metabolites for ibuprofen drug of NSAID, out of which I have just taken one metabolite over here. Iska alcohol ye CH3 ka bhi ban sakta hai. There can be CH2OH over here as well. Then can be this which is converted into CHOH as well. But its major metabolite is the one which occurs at this particular carbon. The reason is it's a tertiary alcohol. And since tertiary alcohol are more stable compared to primary secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol will be in major proportion. Another classical thing with ibuprofen, ibuprofen ka sirf S enantiomer is active. Another important thing to be remembered about ibuprofen, it's only its an S enantiomer which is active. Okay, that was all about oxidation. ऑक्सीडेशन के जो भी पॉसिबल रिएक्शंस थे, ऑक्सीडेशन में जो भी मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द पार्ट वाज देयर, वी हैव कवर्ड एंड टच्ड अपॉन ऑलमोस्ट एवरी पॉसिबल कॉर्नर फ्रॉम वेयर ऑक्सीडेशन कैन अकर. वी विल जस्ट सी अपॉन एग्जांपल्स. of reduction. We'll see few examples of hydrolysis. With regards to cyclization and decyclization, इतना कुछ ज्यादा होता नहीं है, so there is no worries about those two reactions. But yes, उसका जो specific metabolite है, you need to remember that. So when it comes to reduction, we all are aware reduction is opposite to oxidation. Next important thing, since it is opposite to oxidation, वहाँ पे CYP450 चाहिए था. If you remember, हम लोगों ने वहाँ पे group बनाया था, group of monooxygenase enzymes which were required. So there was CYP450 reductase, there was CYP450 heme protein molecular oxygen as well. Same way, यहाँ पे CYP450 will be working in opposite direction, which will be opposite to the ones in which it was acting in oxidation. So the different functional groups which are being obtained after reduction is alcohol. ये group मिलता है reduction के बाद. Aldehyde, you can also get phenones. So it depends what your initial metabolite is. Example is chloramphenicol and your chloral hydrate. Just remember chloramphenicol from example. No need to remember these things. These things we'll see diagrammatically now, so don't worry. Going ahead, hydrolysis का जैसे हम लोग ने देखा था, cleavage of drug molecule by taking up H2O. So we'll be seeing examples of hydrolytic drugs, जहाँ पे hydrolysis से drug degrade होके first pass metabolism होता है उसका. So those hydrolysis example also I have taken in. Examples obviously there will be esters, one of them. So those esters is one way where a prodrug is being made and gets converted into active form. Your procaine and lidocaine, they both are esters only. That's how they work as well. Your procaine and lidocaine, they both are esters. Talking about cyclization, so cyclization mein basically ring structure banta hai from straight chain molecule. Chloramphenicol is basically reduced product after reduction jo milta hai wo. Talking about cyclization, formation of ring structure, so your progranulin is a prodrug. Your progranulin then undergoes cyclization where it is converted into cycloguanyl. So your cycloguanyl is the active moiety, your progranulin is the prodrug. Prodrug, which is progranulin, undergoes cyclization to form cycloguanyl, and your cycloguanyl is the active metabolite. I hope this is very much clear. Going to decyclization. Decyclization basically includes opening up of ring structure. So barbiturates get open up. No need to get in depth with decyclization. Cyclization, I hope you understand. Progranyl se cycloguanyl ka cyclization ho jata. Now let's look after a few examples of reduction and hydrolysis, and then we'll be done with phase one metabolism. First example. I hope you are able to see the example right up on the screen. So your aliphatic aldehydes, jo chlorohydrate ka example tha, I've taken example of that. Chloramphenicol may be there is a carbonyl moiety. We'll look after its structure as well to get it in idea. Probably it's the drug which will then get metabolized. It's not the metabolized part, it is the initial part. It is the substrate on which your reduction will occur to give you the product. So chloral hydrate is over here, CCl3CHO.H2O, that is hydrate form. So ye jo CHO hai, this CHO is nothing but your aliphatic aldehyde, just the way they have shown over here. So when you write aliphatic aldehyde, your aliphatic aldehyde is nothing but C double bond O along with H. So this is your aliphatic aldehyde. After reduction, reduction is nothing but addition of hydrogens. So a hydrogen molecule will get added. So suppose maine do hydrogens add kiye. So after addition, you will get hydrogen over here. You will get a hydrogen over here, and this double bond will actually get converted into a single bond. It will become CHOH, and the rest moiety Cl3C, they will remain the same. I hope the clarity is there. Is everything clear with this example? Can we go ahead? Okay, repeat. So I said that if you check this particular structure, I'll just erase it entirely to give a better idea. If you see this particular structure, this is your carbon. This carbon is along with three chlorines. So main chlorine nahi likh raha hu, it is understood. Then you have your CHO moiety, which is C double bond O and H. Aage ka H2O as it, when it undergoes reduction, reduction is basically of addition of hydrogens. So I have added two nascent hydrogens, or you can add a molecular hydrogen as well. तो मैंने दो हाइड्रोजन ऐड किए, एक हाइड्रोजन यहाँ पे ऐड होगा सी एच के यहाँ पे, अनदर हाइड्रोजन विल बी एडेड ओवर हियर ऑक्सीजन के पास, एंड दिस डबल बॉन्ड विल देन गेट कन्वर्टेड इनटू अ सिंगल बॉन्ड. नाउ व्हाट योर प्रोडक्ट विल लुक एज, इट इज कार्बन, वो कार्बन अटैच टू वन कार्बन विच इज अटैच टू थ्री डिफरेंट क्लोरिन्स. जैसे वो रिएक्टेंट में था, इट इज द सेम इन द प्रोडक्ट. देन योर सी एच ओ इज नाउ कन्वर्टेड इनटू सी, ये रहा वो सी एच टू, तो दिस इज वन एच एंड दिस इज अनदर एच, ये दो हाइड्रोजन हो गए. दिस देन कन्वर्टेड इनटू सी एच टू एंड ओ एच. इज इट क्लियर नाउ? ओके, लेट्स गो अहेड. आई होप यू आर नोटिंग डाउन द एग्जांपल्स पैरेलली. गोइंग टू नेक्स्ट टॉपिक विच इज अ रिडक्शन ऑफ अ कीटोन. यहाँ पे एल्डिहाइड का रिडक्शन किया था, अब कीटोन का रिडक्शन कर रहा हूँ. तो द ड्रग इज मिथाडोन, इट इज बेसिकली ओपियोइड एनाल्जेसिक. मिथाडोन में कीटोन ग्रुप है सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ. यहाँ पे भी एडिशन ऑफ टू नेसेंट हाइड्रोजन्स, हाइड्रोजन्स विल बी एडेड एंड दिस हाइड्रोजन आफ्टर एडिशन विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू अ हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप. देयर इज अ मिस्टेक ओवर हियर, इट शुड हैव हाइड्रोजन, इट्स अ प्रिंटिंग एरर, इट बिकम्स सी एच ओ एच. So now your reduction has given a functional group of alcohol. इसके लिए यहाँ पे groups में alcohol लिखा है. Water molecule will go away. पानी को मेरे को क्या करने का? This one, अच्छा, you are saying of chlorohydrate, it will get released. No worries at all. Is everything clear till here? Are we noting down examples parallelly? इनिशियली सिर्फ ये चैप्टर के लिए ज्यादा एग्जाम्पल्स करने पड़ेंगे, बट हेंस फोर्थ अहेड देयर वोंट बी सो मेनी एग्जाम्पल्स, सो डोंट वरी. नाउ वी आर कमिंग टू नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल. ये एग्जाम्पल एक एस्टर ड्रग का, सो आर गोइंग टू हाइड्रोलिसिस. नाउ रिडक्शन के एग्जाम्पल्स देख लिए. द नेम ऑफ द ड्रग इज क्लोफाइब्रेट. क्लो इज कॉज ऑफ द क्लोरिन ग्रुप इन्वॉल्व. इट बिलोंग्स टू योर फिनोफाइब्रेट्स इफ यू रिकलेक्ट. So over here we can further see benzene के आगे oxygen है, oxygen के बाद आगे carbon है. Your ester moiety is over here, C double bond O O C two H five. Here is your ester moiety. मैं इसका hydrolysis करूँगा, means I'll add HOH to it, just the way we saw for that particular example where we discussed for RC double bond OR. So what will happen? C2H5 will take this OH and it will become C2H5OH, which is your alcohol, and your remaining part of hydrogen will get added to your carboxyl group, which is C double bond OO, and from that C double bond OO it will get converted into carboxylic acid. Is it very much clear till here? So it's the same ester hydrolysis what we did initially. In case of chlorohydrate, if oxygen accepts hydrogen carbocation forms, it can't accept hydrogen molecule. Let's not get into the MOI part of it. हमको इसमें नहीं जाना है, इसके mechanism में and your carbonyl chemistry. But with regards to the reduction process involved over there, that particular carbon will get converted into alcoholic moiety anyway. Radical mechanism and all you can let go of as of now. For chlorofibrate we can do OD alkylation as well. OD alkylation, yes you can do, it will happen at this particular stage. ये OD alkylation होगा, ये पूरा moiety निकल जाएगा. Next example. Next example is of aspirin. Typical example, aspirin के hydrolysis बहुत देखा होगा. In your 12th standard also you might have seen many times. We are taking up the same example ahead. Aspirin is your O एसिटाइल सैलिसिलिक एसिड, सो ये आपका ऑक्सीजन है, विल वी कम टू नो विच रिएक्शन टू डू. इन केस ऑफ योर मेजर मेटाबॉलिक रिएक्शंस फॉर डिफरेंट ड्रग्स, योर एस्टर हाइड्रोलिसिस विल बी द फर्स्ट कॉमन वन. एज आई टोल्ड यू इनिशियली, ओडी अल्काइलेशन एंड एनडी अल्काइलेशन आर नॉट दैट कॉमन कंपेयर्ड टू योर हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन. सो योर फर्स्ट प्रेफर्ड चॉइस इन ऑक्सीडेशन विल ऑलवेज बी हाइड्रोक्सिलेशन. एच को ओएच में कन्वर्ट कर दो, देन यू विल गो टू अदर प्रायोरिटीज. बट इट कैन नॉट बी जनरलाइज के हमेशा किसी को भी ये अप्लाई कर ही सकते. बट यस, आई कैन टेल यू फॉर श्योर व्हेन वी विल गो टू मेटाबॉलिज्म, जहां जहां पे भी ओएच है, जैसे यहाँ पे ओएच है तो मैं इसका ग्लूकुरोनाइड कॉन्जुगेट बना सकता हूँ. 99% ऑफ द टाइम आई कैन कन्वर्ट दिस ओएच इनटू अ ग्लूकुरोनाइड कॉन्जुगेट, जहां पे मैं ये ओएच को ओ जी एल यू लिख दूंगा. ओके, लेट्स गो इट. आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट एस्पिरिन. एस्पिरिन इज ओ एसिटाइल सैलिसिलिक एसिड. सो दिस इज योर एस्टर मेटाबोलाइट, ये सॉरी दिस इज योर एस्टर ड्रग. तो ये एस्टर बना कैसे है, ये बेंजीन के ऊपर है, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ सी एच थ्री. सो दिस इज योर एस्टर. मैंने सिर्फ ओ सी डबल बॉन्ड और सी एच थ्री को ओपन करके लिखा. सो व्हेन यू डू एस्टर हाइड्रोलिसिस फॉर दिस, जब इसका हाइड्रोलिसिस होगा तो वो यहां से ब्रेक होगा. इट विल गेट ब्रेक फ्रॉम हियर. दिस पर्टिकुलर मेड मेटाबोलाइट इज रॉन्ग. व्हाट इट विल बी देन इज फ्रॉम एच टू ओ, योर एच विल गेट एडेड टू दिस ऑक्सीजन, इट विल बिकम ओ एच एंड योर रिमेनिंग एच, ये पूरा एच ओ एच में से आपका हाइड्रोजन इसको जाएगा टू दिस ऑक्सीजन एंड इट विल बिकम ओ एच एंड योर सी एच थ्री सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ दिस ओ एच. योर एसिटिक एसिड विल बी अनदर मेटाबोलाइट. This is a wrongly made metabolite over here. It's a typo error. So it will be acetic acid as another byproduct. Thalidomide. Thalidomide tragedy, if you remember. So thalidomide tragedy, mein, there was a teratogenic metabolite. That teratogenic metabolite is thalidomide. So that is another thing to be remembered. Yes, it's a part of your pharmacology, no doubt. But since we are doing, we can do it together over here. The teratogenic metabolite of thalidomide is thalidomide, which is the major reason why the drug was being withdrawn. So thalidomide ke metabolism mein bhi there are two types of ester hydrolysis being involved over here. So yahan pe jo ester hydrolysis ho raha hai wo hydrolytic time pe, I won't say it is exactly ester hydrolysis, but it is breaking the ring in between. You can somewhere take it as an example of decyclization as well. Ester bond break nahi ho raha, it's a ketone bond which is getting break. I would rather term it as a part of decyclization. Observe this particular ring. Pehle major wala dekhte hain, I'm observing this ring. So what happens at this particular stage is undergoing your hydrolysis, which is again HOH. So ye jo hydrolysis ho raha hai, out of this your hydrogen goes to NH. यहां से ब्रेक होगा, आपका हाइड्रोजन जाएगा NH के पास, and it will become NH2. Further, जो बाकी का पार्ट था C double bond O, वो C double bond O के पास ये OH जाएगा, and it will become carboxylic acid. That's how it works. So a decyclization भी हुआ है यहाँ पे, but actually it is hydrolysis. So the hydrolytic metabolite of thalidomide, which is thalidomide, is found to be teratogenic. Important MCQ as a part of your hydrolytic metabolite as well, and taking into account the drug thalidomide as well. So covering two things parallelly, thalidomide and thalidomide. Is everything clear till here? Aspirin is an ester, then product shouldn't be one acid and one alcohol. Carboxylic aspirin is not an acid, aspirin is an ester. You will consider this part of it O acetyl salicylic acid. So this O acetyl is your ester form. Ye ester basically aage jaake carboxylic acid or alcohol mein convert hota. I'm not taking this carboxylic acid into account. Is the doubt answered?
ओके, दैट वाज योर मेजर मेटाबोलाइट जहां पे थैलेमाइड बना था. नाउ लुकिंग एट योर माइनर मेटाबोलाइट, तो एक बार आपने नीचे का रिंग ब्रेक किया, अब ऊपर का रिंग ब्रेक होगा. सो व्हेन यू आर ब्रेकिंग दिस अपर रिंग, इट इज दिस पार्ट ऑफ द रिंग, यहां से ब्रेक होगा, यहां पे भी एड H2O ही होने वाला. सो इट इज योर HOH व्हिच इज गेटिंग एडेड. आउट ऑफ दिस योर H प्रीवियस केस विल गो टू योर नाइट्रोजन एंड देन दिस N विल बिकम NH. ये रहा, वो N से NH हो गया. रेस्ट एवरीथिंग स्टेज द सेम, ये रिंग एज इट इज. तो H गया नाइट्रोजन के पास, जो पेंडिंग OH था इट हैज गॉन टू योर कार्बन. So now this C double bond O has got converted into COOH. This is known as glutaramide derivative. So it was not the glutaramide derivative of thalidomide which was teratogenic. It was the thalamide derivative of thalidomide which was teratogenic. दो काम एक साथ हो रहा है. हम लोग specific ADRs पे भी जा रहे हैं. We are seeing metabolism of drugs as well. So tomorrow when you will see these drugs in individual, like diazepam as a part of sedative hypnotics, aspirin as a part of NSAID, you will already be knowing this. Is everything clear till here? Have we noted down these examples as well?
Sir, hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, I was asking that hydrolysis of ester forms one acid and one alcohol, right?
Yes, one alcohol then, and one acid.
Yeah, then how come hydrolysis of aspirin formed salicylic acid and acetic acid?
So your alcohol is your, okay, Are don't go with the terminologies. It is specific to the functional group. So one metabolite was your acetic acid, which is your carboxylic acid, this CH3C double bond OOH, and the other functional group which got breakdown as a part of your ester group is alcohol. So this is your functional moiety of alcohol. The reason why this is known as salicylic acid is iske paas pehle ka carboxylic acid pada hai, that's why it is known as salicylic acid.
Okay.
Or else your ester functionality can break into alcohol and acid only.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, methadone ka second example, I guess you said thalidomide probably. In case of your thalidomide, first part, the major metabolite was the one where it is getting break from this part of the ring. The reaction is hydrolysis. Hydrolysis is nothing but HOH. So your hydrogen has gone to this particular NH, and this NH is now being converted into NH2. The remaining part of the moiety, which is OH, has now gone to this carbonyl group C double, and it is then converted into COOH. The minor metabolite of it, which is again undergoing hydrolysis, the ring is getting break from here. Your nitrogen is taking this hydrogen and it is getting converted into NH. The remaining part, jo carbonyl ka C double bond O, it is getting oxygen and it is, sorry, the C double bond O is getting the remaining part, which is OH, and it is getting converted into carboxylic acid. I hope it's clear till you. Maitha, is methadone clear? I just said that it will get break from up over here. Over here it will get break from down. Hydrolysis hoga. Just ye part ko cut kar dena. Sorry, here it will, I'm just sorry. I'll just repeat it again. When it is the major metabolite, that time hydrolysis is occurring with HOH. Wo jab hydrolysis ho raha, that time it is getting break over here. Your hydrogen goes to this particular NH, and that NH after getting that hydrogen becomes NH2. On the other hand, this OH goes to this particular carbonyl carbon, yahan pe C double bond O hai, and a C double bond O after getting that OH will become COOH. Going to the minor product, it will get break from here. After breaking, this hydrogen will go to nitrogen and it will become NH. Here raha wo NH, rest is additives. And this carbonyl group, which was C double bond O, will go become COOH. There is no need to add all the structures. Thalidomide ka thalamide metabolite yaad rakhna. Sirf thalamide ka naam bhi yaad rakha, toh it's more than enough. There is no need to get into individual structures. Nowhere. All right. Going to some specific inhibitor of biotransformation. It is just for some drug-drug interaction to be highlighted. If you are giving ciprofloxacin and theophylline, there will be theophylline toxicity. Theophylline will accumulate in the body. Reason being, ciprofloxacin and many other drugs like ciprofloxacin, they inhibit your CYP enzymes. And this CYP enzymes are basically the one which are involved in metabolism of theophylline. Theophylline ka metabolism inhibit ho jata hai. Theophylline ka metabolism nahi hota hai if there is inhibition of CYP enzymes. So when you give your ciprofloxacin and theophylline together, your ciprofloxacin will inhibit CYP enzymes, due to which your metabolism of theophylline will not occur. Theophylline ka metabolism nahi hoga, the drug won't go outside the human body and it will go on accumulating, which will then lead to toxicity. So ciprofloxacin and theophylline should not be given together. Reason being, ciprofloxacin inhibits the CYP enzymes which are involved in metabolism of theophylline. Going ahead, some other examples, there are many fruit juices as well. Like you take example of grapefruit juice. Grapefruit juice basically contains an inhibitor of CYP3A4. So all those drugs which are metabolized by CYP3A4, simple example again of theophylline, wo bhi CYP3A4 se metabolize hota. So if you give grapefruit juice and your theophylline together, in that case theophylline will again get accumulated. Okay, coming to phase 2 now. Phase 2 mein zyada kuch hai nahi, so there is nothing to worry except this particular table from which we need to buy out a good number of things. Rest, phase 2 is very small, there is nothing to stress upon, will be very specific. So first part, as we know, jo bhi drugs phase 2 metabolism ke liye aane wale hai, उन सबका कॉन्जुगेशन ही होने वाला है. एंड दिस ड्रग्स विच आर गोइंग टू कम फॉर फेज टू मेटाबॉलिज्म, आइदर इट विल बी फेज वन मेटाबोलाइट, मतलब जो फेज वन से मेटाबॉलिज्म हो गया है, आइदर दे विल बी दोज ड्रग्स और दे मे बी एन एंडोजीनियस सब्सट्रेट. सो व्हेन यू से एंडोजीनियस सब्सट्रेट, वी वर बेसिकली मीनिंग द ड्रग्स विच विल एंटर फेज टू, दे वोंट कम आफ्टर फेज वन, दे डायरेक्टली एंटर योर फेज टू रिएक्शंस. They may be derived from carbs or amino acid, and the most important thing, your conjugation reactions have high energy requirement. It requires a lot of ATP when it comes to your any type of conjugation reactions. So there are different types of conjugation reactions. This image is as it is from your Brahmankar. We need to buy out few things from this particular image when it comes to your phase 2 metabolism. One thing we have already noted, ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन सबसे ज्यादा होता है, सो वी नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट. द रीजन व्हाई योर ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन अकर्स टू अ वेरी ग्रेट एक्सटेंट इज द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द एंजाइम्स विच आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन. द एंजाइम्स विच आर इन्वॉल्व्ड इन योर ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन इज बेसिकली योर यूडीपी ग्लुकुरोनिल ट्रांसफरेज. सो दिस एंजाइम इज प्रेजेंट टू अ वेरी ग्रेट एक्सटेंट इन ह्यूमन सिस्टम, दैट्स द रीजन ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन अकर्स मेजरली. The conjugating agent is glucuronic acid. So when it comes to any conjugation, मुझे बहुत सी चीजें बायट करनी है. पहली चीज, glucuronidation occurs to the maximum extent. Second चीज, उसमें कौन सा enzyme involved होता है. So let it be any conjugation reaction, we need to remember the name of enzymes of all of them. मेरे को सब conjugation के enzyme के नाम याद रखने पड़ेंगे. I don't have any other option. I have to remember them. Going ahead, after the name of your conjugating agent, next important thing is that attach what is the conjugating agent. So when I say conjugating agent is glucuronic acid, so all those drugs which have a functional group of hydroxyl on them, jaise paracetamol ho gaya, maine paracetamol ka example dekha tha. I'll just draw the paracetamol moiety over here. Paracetamol basically kya tha, ek benzene ring tha. वो बेंजीन रिंग पे एक साइड OH था और एक साइड पे NH C डबल बॉन्डो CH3 था. जस्ट अज्यूम देयर इज NH C डबल बॉन्डो CH3 ओवर हियर. आई एम नॉट गेटिंग मच इनटू दैट, सो आई एम जस्ट फोकसिंग ऑन दिस हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप. सो योर ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन रिएक्शन अकर्स एट ऑल दोस पोजीशन वेयर देयर इज OH COOH NH2 SH. मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द टाइम इट हैपेंस विद OH. तो जितने भी ड्रग्स पे ऊपर OH होगा ना, यू कैन कन्वर्ट दैट OH ग्लुकुरोनाइड मॉइटी राइटिंग इट OGLU. तो हम लोग ग्लुकुरोनिडेशन बेसिकली सिर्फ GLU लिख के सिग्निफाई करते हैं. इट मींस दैट इट इज अ ग्लुकुरोनाइड मॉइटी. नो नीड टू गेट इनटू एक्टिव इंटरमीडिएट. अगर हम चार कॉलम कर रहे हैं, वी आर डूइंग दिस, वी आर डूइंग दिस, वी आर डूइंग दिस एज वेल, इफ पॉसिबल डू दिस कॉलम एज वेल, बट सबसे ज्यादा सिग्निफिकेंस ये दो कॉलम्स पे रखना. फॉर क्वेश्चन टू कम एज इट इज, फॉर एन एमसीक्यू टू कम एज इट इज, इट विल बी आस्किंग द कॉन्जुगेटिंग एजेंट एंड द ट्रांसफरिंग एंजाइम. ये दोनों ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है when it comes to your entrances, your second column and your third column. Non-polar drug ka polar mein conversion phase 1 mein ho jata hai, phase 2 mein to wo conjugate ban ke aur easily bahar jayega body se. Conjugation basically involves attachment of a more solubilizing moiety which will help in easy excretion. Some functional moieties basically get attached in your conjugation step. Hum conjugation reactions chemistry mein bhi karte hai, just like your coupling and all. So you just attach one moiety to another moiety majorly. All right, so that was about conjugation. If you go to sulfation, sulfation mein ideally it should be sulfonation. Book ke andar hi spelling mistake hai, it's sulfonation. In sulfonation the enzyme involved is sulfotransferase. I repeat, in sulfonation the enzyme involved is sulfotransferase. Sulfotransferase mein sulfate moiety is getting attached. You can see the second column. In sulfotransferase your sulfate moiety gets attached. So it's your hydroxyl group. Ye hydroxyl group jaise isme hai a paracetamol ka to o glucuronidation hi hota hai, o sulfate moiety you won't find, but there are few drugs jisme wapas same way OH hoga at the terminal. And you can make a sulfate conjugate of it. So your sulfate moiety will get attached. When you say it's a sulfate, actually write SO3H. You don't write SO2. You write SO3H. I hope it's clear till here. Going to amino acid conjugation. So amino acid conjugation, मैंने वो स्लाइड में बोला था जहां पे हम लोग फेज 1 फेज 2 साथ में डिस्कस कर रहे थे, दैट अमीनो एसिड कंजुगेशन वाज नथिंग बट योर ग्लाइसिन कंजुगेशन. वहां पे लिखा तो ग्लाइसिन ही था. द एंजाइम व्हिच इज इन्वॉल्वड इन योर अमीनो एसिड कंजुगेशन और ग्लाइसिन कंजुगेशन इज नथिंग बट योर असाइल ट्रांसफरेजेस. द एंजाइम व्हिच इज इन्वॉल्वड इन योर अमीनो एसिड और ग्लाइसिन कंजुगेशन इज बेसिकली असाइल ट्रांसफरेजेस. So glycine conjugation, basically glycine entire amino acid gets attached. That's how it goes. Again, uske liye bhi susceptible moieties is your carboxylic acid and amine group, COOH and NH2. I hope you are noting down things parallelly. Going to next one, glutathione. Glutathione ka enzyme is glutathione S transferases. It will transfer the glutathione moiety. Your glutathione moiety gets added. As we saw initially, glutathione and sulfate conjugation is the third most conjugation which usually occurs. In case of acetylation, N-acetyl transferase is the enzyme and it transfers acetyl CoA. So the group which will get attached would be acetyl CoA. And the last one, when it comes to methylation, the enzyme involved is methyl transferases, and what gets attached is your methyl group. Conjugating agent is L-methionine, that's the amino acid if you remember. Methionine, jo group attached hota, that is methyl group. So your OH will then become OCH3. Your NH2 will then become NHCH3. Your SH will then become SCH3. And if you remember, we recently did replication transcription. Transcription mein post-transcriptional modification tha. For those who were a part of that lecture, post-transcriptional modification mein, there was capping at pi dash end with methyl guanosine. For 7-methyl guanosine, mein, methyl group came from this only, S-adenosyl methionine. So it's the same enzyme. Amino acid conjugation. Amino acid conjugation mein amino acids join ho jata directly. So if I take example of glycine, glycine is an amino acid jiska sequence bada hai. Glycine will get added. So OH, suppose ye COH ka example diya hai. If you see structures of glycine conjugation, वो COH के आगे पूरा ग्लाइसिन मॉइटी अटैच हो जाएगा, सिर्फ हाइड्रोजन निकल जाएगा और हाइड्रोजन के बदले इट वुड बी C डबल बॉन्ड O O एंड देन ग्लाइसिन मॉइटी ऐड. हियर आई हैव जस्ट टेकन अप एवरीथिंग टुगेदर. एज सच इसमें कुछ इम्पोर्टेंट नहीं है, जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्यू थिंग्स इन अ बेटर वे. ओके, सो अगर ग्लूटाथायन कॉन्जुगेशन में द एंजाइम विच इज इन्वॉल्व इज ग्लूटाथायन एस ट्रांसफरेज, दिस एंजाइम विल बेसिकली कॉन्जुगेट ग्लूटाथायन मॉइटी एंड दिस ग्लूटाथायन कॉन्जुगेशन यूजुअली अकर्स अक्रॉस योर इपॉक्साइड्स. सो एक इपॉक्साइड का रिएक्शन है, विल टेक इट अप इन द अपकमिंग सेशंस, दैट ग्लूटाथायन कॉन्जुगेट इज एक्चुअली हिपैटोटॉक्सिक इन दैट केस. That conjugate itself, yes, the glutathione conjugate itself is toxic. All right, let's go ahead. So first thing, there are a few more MCQs which are being connected on this slide. First thing, jo glucuronide conjugation hota hai, after glucuronide conjugation, the weight increases to a good extent of your metabolite, and your glucuronide conjugation favors excretion in bile. Important MCQ, glucuronide conjugation occurs via which route? So it is basically via bile excretion. Then with regards to endogenous substrates which utilize glucuronidation as a pathway, so you have your hormones and your thyroxin as well, which utilizes glucuronide conjugation as a pathway to be excreted in bile. Just note down example. So glucuronide conjugation, it is excreted via bile. And the endogenous substrates which are susceptible to it are hormones and thyroxine basically. Even levothyroxine and thyroxine are hormones only. So they are, so this is steroidal hormones as well as other hormones. Going to next one, acetylation. Acetylation mein basically N-acetyltransferase is the enzyme which is involved, as we saw in the previous slide. And we all know rate of acetylation shows genetic polymorphism. So some population are fast acetylators and some population are slow acetylators. Anyone remembers which population is belonging to slow acetylators? It's a geographic.
Okay. Caucasians.
A bit closer. Basically, if you see your Caucasians along with a lot of Egyptians are the major ones which are slow acetylators. You will find this word specifically being given in Brahmankar chapter during the chapter of absorption. They have connected it with absorption as well. So due to genetic polymorphism, which is regional dependency as well, like Egyptians, more than around 75% to 80% of Egyptians are slow acetylators, which is not the case with us. We are fast acetylators. So jo drug acetylation se metabolism karke excrete hote hai, those drugs will go immediately from our systems. But that same drug will have a longer duration of action while it will come to Egyptian patients. Because उन लोग में उतने enzymes नहीं होते that they can be easily excreted. That's the reason whenever you want any drug to be launched, it is studied at multiple geographical places. It not just at one stage. That is usually phase 3 part of the metabolism. Clinical trials का phase 3 होता है, जहाँ पे एक बहुत बड़ा population which belongs to different regions, different food habits, everything is being taken into consideration. When it comes to your methylation basically we all know there are two amino acids which are containing methyl, methionine and cysteine bhi hota hai. So it's major, methionine is hydroxyl as well, serine threonine, okay, methionine is sulfur only, sorry, serine and threonine are your hydroxyl amino acids, we'll cover that later. So your methyl donors would be your methionine and cysteine over here. Going to the last part, glycine, which was your amino acid conjugation, is the third major one along with glutathione. As we saw, it's not that greatly coming in sulfate conjugation. We already saw the enzyme, it was sulfotransferases, and there was one more ribonucleoside nucleotide synthesis. it's not being used that greatly, so let's not focus upon that. We'll stick to our first six metabolites only. First one, list of prodrugs. So there were many in the list. Aspirin, then we had chloramphenicol, you had enalapril. There were a list of some 4 to 5 drugs, phenacetin. Types of biotransformation, so it was the most simplest question, phase 1 and phase 2. Primary site of metabolism is your liver. Metabolism occurs at liver. Least metabolism occurs at skin. Different names of phase 1 metabolism. So functionalization was one. Then non-synthetic was another. Phase 2 ke bhi dusre do naam the, same way. Conjugation and non-synthetic. Then phase 2 metabolites are not active, except there are two metabolites which are being phase 2 and still active. One is glucuronide conjugate of morphine. Another is sulfate conjugate of minoxidil. Your phase 1 metabolite will never, you can never say that phase 1 metabolite will always result in inactivation. Your prodrugs get activated after phase 1 metabolism. So it's a different way. Your phase 2 metabolism includes glucuronide conjugation majorly. Glucuronide conjugations are not excreted via urine. The answer is false. They're excreted majorly via bile. Ester drugs are converted into carboxylic acid and alcohols. Yes, example is aspirin, which was being salicylic acid and acetic acid. Name the enzymes involved in glucuronidation and acetylation. Acetylation N-acetyl transferase, glucuronidation UDPGA, I guess. Teratogenic metabolite of thalidomide is thalimide. S-isomer of ibuprofen is active. Active metabolite of aspirin is salicylic acid. Yes, diazepam is not a prodrug. Diazepam itself is active, and diazepam ka metabolite, which is oxazepam, even that is active. So diazepam is a prodrug ka answer no aega, it's false. Diazepam itself is active, and the active metabolite of diazepam is oxazepam. And then you have ciprofloxacin and theophylline. They cannot be given together. Simple reason being, your ciprofloxacin inhibits the enzymes which are involved in metabolism of theophylline. I hope all the questions are being answered. Anyone wants answer for any of the questions from this? Anyone needs any answer for any of the questions from this? Last one. So ciprofloxacin and theophylline cannot be given together. Ciprofloxacin inhibits your CYP enzymes. You saw drug-drug interaction. So your ciprofloxacin inhibits CYP enzymes, cytochrome P450, cytochrome P3A4, and all those enzymes. These enzymes are involved in metabolism of theophylline. Agar ye enzymes inhibit kar diye to theophylline ka metabolism nahi hoga, due to which theophylline will not be excreted out of the human system. It will get built up in the system, leading to toxicity. That's the reason ciprofloxacin and theophylline cannot be given together. It is S-isomer of ibuprofen, which is active. I can see question 6 and question 7. So question number 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Are phase 2 metabolites active? If yes, name them. So yes, phase 2 metabolites can be active. We saw there were two phase 2 metabolites which were active. One was glucuronide conjugate of your morphine. Another one was your sulfate conjugate of minoxidil. So these two being phase 2 metabolites are active. Does phase 1 metabolite always inactivate the drug? Answer is false. Phase 1 metabolism, it should be phase 1 metabolism as a word. Sorry for the typo error. Your phase 1 metabolism doesn't necessarily result in inactivation. As we saw, phase 1 metabolism can also activate the drug if the drug is prodrug. If you remember, phase 1 metabolism matlab hum ye side ki baat kar rahe. We are talking about this. Phase 1 metabolism. Phase 1 metabolism ke baad mein your prodrugs actually get activated. So your phase 1 metabolism doesn't necessarily result in inactivation of drug. It can actually activate the drug as well. Is it clear till here? 6th and 7th, both questions answered. Anyone has any more doubts? Examples. Anurag Mishra, you were saying about example for which question? Question 6. Okay, I said you the example. It was glucuronide conjugate and your sulfate conjugate. These two examples. I was talking about these two examples. Okay. All right. So it was a great time in. We are done with the entire biotransformation. You can apply this commonly to all the types of drugs. Is there anyone who can revise this entire thing in 5 minutes? We'll go right from slide number one.
So in starting, we saw biotransformation, ADME, that is absorption, when the drug gets into the bloodstream, distribution, it gets to the site of action, metabolism, where the drug is changed so that it can be excreted, and elimination, when the drug leaves the body. Lipophilic, mostly the drug is lipophilic in nature. It is so that it can easily cross the membrane, but while excretion, it hinders the excretion process.
So we need to have an optimal balance of HLB.
HLB, okay. So while renal excretion, the drug should be hydrophilic in nature. Biotransformation, by the process of biotransformation, when the drug is non-polar or lipid soluble, then it gets converted into polar or water soluble. But when the drug itself is hydrophilic in nature, then there is no need for biotransformation, or very little biotransformation takes place. The major primary site of drug site for metabolism is liver, and also kidney, intestine, lungs, and plasma, where skin metabolism is least in skin or at the site of skin. So this is the table where we saw when the drug is active and metabolite is inactive, an effect is due to the parent drug, and examples were ibuprofen, lidocaine, and paracetamol. Next, where the drug and metabolism both were active and pharmacological action was because of parent as well as metabolite. Example was codeine, morphine, digitoxin, digoxin, diazepam, oxazepam. Third, where the drug itself was inactive and the metabolite was active in the case of prodrugs. And they were more stable, the bioavailability of these drugs were more. And examples were levodopa into dopamine, enalapril into enalaprilate. These were some of the examples where we saw the drug itself, both were active, drug as well as metabolite, but there was no pharmacological activity. Change in the pharmacological activity. Example was amitriptyline and noramitriptyline, and imipramine and desimipramine. Change in the pharmacological action was seen in ipranazid, where it was antidepressant, but isoniazid was antitubercular. Diazepam was tranquilizer, and oxazepam was anticonvulsant.
Okay, let's go ahead. Prodrugs list.
Okay. List of prodrugs inactive was aspirin and salicylic acid, phenacetin into paracetamol, sulfasalazine into mesalamine, and pivoamphicine, ampicillin into ampicillin, enalapril into enalaprilat. Chloramphenicol, palmitate into chloramphenicol. This is the classification of biotransformation where we saw phase one and phase two reaction. Some drugs, they undergo phase one reaction where when the drug is hydrophobic in nature, and then they undergo oxidation, reduction, and hydrolysis. Sometimes it also undergoes cyclization and decyclization. Some of the drugs which are hydrophobic, they can directly enter into phase two metabolism. Some of phase one metabolism, it is also called as non-synthetic or functionalization. Functional group is generator or exposed, and metabolite, it may be active or inactive. Active in the case of prodrugs, as we saw. In phase two, synthetic or conjugation, metabolism is metabolite is mostly inactive. Exception is glucuronide conjugate of morphine and sulfate conjugate of minoxidil. Other reactions are glucuronide conjugation, acetylation, methylation, sulfate conjugation, glycine conjugation, glucothione conjugation, in which glucuronide conjugation is maximum. Second maximum is glycine conjugation. Third is sulfate and glucothione conjugation. Next, we saw phase one in detail, where lipophilic it is converted into polar molecule and introducing or unmasking of the functional group. Pharmacological action of the drug, it can be increased or decreased, or it may be unaltered. In oxidation, we saw hydrolysis of ester, and we get carboxylic acid and alcohol as the products. Oxidation, it involves addition of oxygen and removal of hydrogen. The enzymes or monooxygenase enzymes responsible for the oxidation in liver are CYP450 hemopoietin, CYP450 reductase, O2 and NADPH. Various oxidation reactions were hydroxylation, oxygenation at carbon, nitrogen, sulfur atoms, NO dealkylation, and oxidative deamination, where oxidative deamination and oxygenation at CN or S were released or rare.
Okay, great going. Thanks. I'll continue now. So okay, to go ahead, then we saw example of acetanilate pe hydroxylation kiya to you get paracetamol. Further we saw example of N-oxide jahan pe imipramine ke nitrogen pe N-oxide formation kiya tha. Then we saw phenothiazine where sulfur pe we had S-oxide formation. Going ahead, we saw oxidation of olefins where across the double bond a epoxide ring was being formed, which was further hydrolyzed to give you a diols. Going ahead, for oxidation of benzylic carbon atoms on benzene, there was CH3, which was then undergoing oxidation to get converted from CH3 to CH2H, further oxidized to give you aldehyde, and then oxidized to give you carboxylic acid. Then we saw example of diazepam, where oxidation of carbon atom was alpha to your carbonyl and amines. So that particular carbon got oxidized, wherein that H was being converted into hydroxyl metabolite, and they both are active. Then we saw another example wherein oxidation of carbon atoms was being considered. We took into consideration valproic acid. Valproic acid's metabolite, which was secondary alcohol, that is the major product since that is more stable. The primary alcohol, which is formed over here at terminal, is the minor product. Then we saw example of ibuprofen, in which the tertiary alcohol is majorly stable. So the tertiary alcohol has majority part of your product, and at the same time it is the S enantiomer of your ibuprofen which is more active. Going ahead, we saw other phase one reactions like reduction, hydrolysis, cyclization and decyclization. Reduction was exactly opposite to oxidation, where CYP450 would also work the other way around. Drugs like chloramphenicol and chlorhydrate are your substrates. The groups involved are alcohol, aldehyde and quinones, while in hydrolysis simple H2 would be acting upon your choline esters. Cyclization mein cyclization hoga, your proguanyl will be converted into cycloguanyl, and in decyclization the ring will open up. We went on to see a few example of reduction. So we saw chlorohydrate jahan pe CHO got converted into CH2OH, which was alcohol. Then we saw methadone jahan pe ye ketone group got converted into COOH. Going ahead, we saw example of clofibrate. Clofibrate was a ester, so we saw hydrolysis basically, but this ester was then converted into carboxylic acid and alcohol. After that, next example we saw was of aspirin, where your ester bond was being breaked and you got the active metabolite of salicylic acid and acetic acid over here. We then saw thalidomide, for which the toxic metabolite was teratogenic, which was thalidomide as the metabolite, the teratogenic one. Another one was glutaramide derivative, where both the places your ring was getting broke and it was hydrolysis metabolism. Then we saw the action of drug which can occur between ciprofloxacin and theophylline due to the action of ciprofloxacin wherein it enzymes. And also you cannot give grapefruit juice since they contain an inhibitor of CYP3A4. It cannot be given to patients taking theophylline again. Then we started with phase 2 metabolism. In phase 2 metabolism, we saw that it is majorly for conjugation of the drug, which can occur to a phase 1 metabolite. So product of phase 1 may undergo conjugation. Generally, it's in carbohydrate or in amino acid, and conjugation reactions are high energy requirement. In case of a conjugation reactions, different example are glucuronidation, sulfonation, amino acid conjugation, glutathione, acetylation, methylation. Glucuronidation occurs to the maximum extent. The enzymes which are involved is UDP glucuronyl transferases, and the conjugating agent is glucuronic acid. The intermediate not required as such. Ye wala column itna important nahi hai. The groups which can combine is OH, COH, NH2SH. For sulfonation, it is sulfotransferase as the enzyme, while the sulfate moiety gets attached. In your amino acid conjugation, it is glycine conjugation with the help of enzyme acyl transferases. In your glutathione, it is glutathione S transferases, which has conjugating agent of your glutathione. Your acetylation with the help of enzyme N-acetyl transferases. And the methylation will be with the help of methyl transferases, where the donating one is S-adenosylmethionine. Then we saw glucuronate conjugation favors its excretion via bile. It can be used for endogenous substrates like steroidal hormones and thyroxine. Acetylation was with the help of N-acetyl transferases. There are slow and fast acetylators. So Egyptians are the slow acetylators. So for them, the duration of reaction will be prolonged since the drug is not metabolized. Methylation has methionine and cysteine as the donors. For sulfate conjugation, it was by sulfotransferases. Glutathione conjugation was the one along with glycine conjugation, which occurs majorly at third maximum position after your glucuronidation and amino acid conjugation. That's it. Thanks for your time. I hope the topic is entirely clear. Hence, whichever farm chem drug we see, you should be able to predict what are its possible metabolites. 99% of the times you will go correct. H ka hydroxyl group banega hai, that oxidation will always occur. Further, glucuronidation will always take place. Glucuronidation is a very common metabolite. So that will always happen. I hope the chapter is very much clear, right from pharmacological part as well as farm chem part, and we are very much clear for our entrance as well. If you have any doubts, any queries, text me on WhatsApp, and the number from where you got logins, if you are interested for confirmation and get started with the test series phase or the preparation for our regular lectures, you can text on the same number. It will keep you updated. Classroom students will soon have a test on this as well. Within a week, we'll be having test on biotransformation, antidiabetics, NSAIDs, and replication transcription, what we are done with. Thanks a lot to everyone. All the best. Target GPAT AIR01. Thank you so much. Thank you.